Within the quiet hills of the mountain valley town of Boonville, Arkansas, located a mere 60 miles southeast of Fort Smith, lies the remnants of the Arkansas Tuberculosis Sanitarium. Though the majority of the buildings still stand on the 998-acre property, mostly vacant, the memories within the walls of these buildings are still extremely prevalent. For being a place intended on being a sanctuary, this place became a place of terror, misery, pain, and loss to any surviving former patient or to those who have had family there. Tuberculosis, or TB as it's commonly known, has been recognized and identified since the beginning of time. Skeletal remains from the Neolithic settlements in the eastern Mediterranean show TB to be found in prehistoric humans, as well as tubercular decay in the mummified remains of ancient Egyptians. Hippocrates identified TB around 460 BC as a horrible, widespread disease involving coughing up blood and fever, which was almost always fatal. Prior to the Industrial Revolution, TB was regarded in a more paranormal term and sense, most prominently as a form of vampirism, as when one family member died, the remainder of the family was doomed to the same fate, as was the belief the original family member would drain the life of the rest of the family. It's also been regarded as a witch's curse of turning the victims into horses at night to ride to their meetings, thus their lack of rest, as well as the victims being forced to nightly attend fairy revels. On March 24, 1882, Dr. Robert Koch, a German physician and scientist, presented his discovery of the microbacterium, which is the bacteria that causes tuberculosis. He presented his knowledge to the public about the true cause of TB, which then dispelled the folklore of TB's origins. Tuberculosis is known to attack the lungs, but it can also affect other parts of the body, such as the nervous system. Being an airborne and liquid contagion, an epidemic was bound to happen with new people coming from all around the world into America in large masses. The turn of the 20th century broke TB into epidemic proportions and thus called for sanitariums to be built across the nation. In the fall of 1905, Judge Joseph M. Hill of Fort Smith was diagnosed with the disease and petitioned to the government, both state and federal, to have a facility built for the quarantine, study, and treatment for the disease. Judge Hill relocated himself to Arizona for the hope that the warm, dry air would cure his ailments. 5 years later, on March 31, 1909, Arkansas legislation passed Act 378 that appropriated $50,000 for the establishment of a sanitarium and an additional $30,000 for 2 years of maintenance. Legislators called for an oversight committee charged to seek out land in which to build the sanitarium for the region. The hamlet of Boonville offered 973 acres of land in the hills southeast of town for only $10,000. The oversight committee surveyed the property and concluded that the crisp, clean mountain air would provide the ideal atmosphere for those suffering from the disease, and they accepted the offer. Building began almost immediately and continued for another 60 years. The original plans called for one ward building, four cottages, two for men and two for women, four cabins, five tent houses, and one superintendent's cottage. The first patient was admitted on August 2, 1910. The sanitarium was capable of housing 64 patients with donations by prominent families from Fort Smith and organizations of the area, such as the Masons. Additional buildings were constructed to expand the increase the patients' capacity of the property. A school was made out of the Masons' building. A farming operation was built and incorporated into the property complex with dairy cattle, beef cattle, other livestock, hay, and vegetable crops to supply the food demand of the hospital. A fire department, phone system, water and sewage system were also built into the property, turning the sanitarium into its own community above the original hamlet of Boonville in the valley down below. In 1938, the Nicholas Nyberg Act was passed, funding the construction of the new hospital building on the grounds. This act was promoted and pushed by Phillips County Representative Leo E. Nyberg, who was suffering from living in and would eventually die at the sanitarium. The new Nyberg building was state-of-the-art, spanning 528 feet in length, 5 stories in height, with a full basement and capable of housing 512 beds. The building was capable of housing x-rays, a morgue, and full kitchens. The building was completed and opened again in 1941, a year after the passing of Senator Nyberg. By the end of the construction, the property housed 76 buildings across its property. The facility saw over 70,000 people, but the disease and the lack of educated treatment left a 70-80% mortality rate, creating a sense of fear which impacted the place. Prior to the 1950s, treatments were basically primitive in nature, building solidly on rest, going out into the crisp mountain air, as well as eating regular meals as prescribed in the Victorian era. Surgeries were attempted, which would deflate the lungs, and they used sterilized ping pong balls to keep them deflated. Removal of the phrenic nerve, which was a long spaghetti-like cord that connects the spinal column to the diaphragm. And thoracoplasty, in which a large chunk of the ribs and muscles of the chest are surgically removed to make the afflicted lung collapse. Many of these treatments, such as they were pioneered or refined at the Arkansas State TB Sanitarium, in which they also quickly became the standard across the nation. More medical advances after the 1950s curbed the growing epidemic as well as actually helping the afflicted beat the disease, and thus a decline in the population was to be had. The last patient of the hospital checked out in 1973, forever closing the doors on the location of the TB Sanitarium Hospital.
Park here, Christy?
No, I would park back behind, brother.
Okay.
Welcome to the Nyberg building of a Southern Arkansas State Hospital in the mountains just south of Fort Smith, Arkansas. This compound we are currently on is home to this hospital. It ran pretty much as its own municipal center, municipal water, sewage. There's a chapel right up the hill. There's a school building. But tonight we're going to be here at the morgue. Or not here in the morgue, we're going to be here at this hospital that also houses the morgue, the complex. The community was established due to the Act of 378 of 1909 when a tuberculosis plague hit the central United States. Several government officials at the state level, including a judge and several senators, were diagnosed and suffered from tuberculosis, causing the need for the governor to want a place up in the mountains where the crisp, clean mountain air will help heal the ailments of the people suffering. The original compound, the original hospital, was at the Masonic Building, accepted its first patient in 1910. The complex itself ran from till 1973, 83 years of history. In 1959, the population here on this complex was over 1,000 people. I believe it's 1,017 people, which was greater than the city just down below in the valley. This building we're going to be in tonight was named after Senator Leo Nyberg, who died shortly before the building's completion in 1941. It spans 590 feet in length, with five floors and then a basement which houses the morgue, capable of 512 beds.
So why is it haunted?
Well, that's what we're here to find out. Of course, with any hospital, any tuberculosis, actually any plague, any epidemic that would strike a major populace, such as an entire state that would have this much population, there's going to be unfinished business, there's going to be unlived lives, there's going to be unwed marriages or unwed commitments. There's going to be parents who have lost their children. There's going to be children who have lost their parents. Any energy from that kind of trauma will stay with a place and leave its patients still wandering the halls, seeking help, seeking their loved ones, and seeking to conclude their business that they need finished.
So let's go find us some ghosts, right?
Let's do it.
We got a storm rolling in, as we can see
from
behind us.
Yes.
It's going to make it a much more interesting night, I'm assuming.
And for you kids at home who don't know, who haven't paid attention thus far, when you have storms such as this massive storm rolling in behind me, the ionization in the air charges the air with negative ions, giving more static into the air, which gives the entities that we're going to go try to find more energy so they can come out and play with us.
Let's go.
Let's do it.
The silhouette.
Walk through the little morgue entrance. I said this place is massively huge. But it was really pretty at one time, too.
Oh, it was beautiful. It was state of the art.
At least some of the floors have electricity still, huh?
Oh, and there's a farm here.
Farm?
There's a farm. The complex had its own farm, state-of-the-art milking equipment for fresh dairy.
Yeah, I heard they produced everything here.
They had everything here. They were.
Well, you know why though, right?
Oh yeah, because they didn't want the infection getting out.
That's right.
I mean, that was one of the purposes of this place, was to have a place where they can contain and control, examine, and understand the disease, trying to keep it contained, keep it from spreading. That's what the Act of 1938. The three main purposes of the sanatorium were to search for tuberculosis among the people of the Arkansas population and to see to their supervision and treatment. To search for the people who had exposed to the infection and give them repeated examinations, and to weed out tuberculosis among the people who appeared to be well, even those who had no known contact of the disease. Those are the three main purposes of the Act of 378.
Here's a little morgue entrance. Having a hard time focusing. Kind of move your flashlight to the left. There we go. It's like a little entrance way that's off to the side of the building connected.
There's the entrance on that glass.
There?
Over actually on that one too, but also that one.
I can't see them to the IR. Oh, I see up in the white.
Yeah.
Yeah. So let's take a walk. Like through the death tunnel.
I don't have my digital recorder with me.
I don't either. Mine's inside the building.
Yep.
Those old doors, huh? And notice, what was that?
A bird.
Okay. Notice how the doors have where you can push them. No, no door handles, just where you can push. Did you hear that too? Camera focus.
There's something calling us.
Yep, I heard a footstep. Some of the other members are not behind us.
No.
Let them follow. That weird too is how it's got the stone, then it turns over to
the brick.
Lighter brick, yeah.
Yeah.
More of the buildings. Some of the community is still very active today. There's still people who live around the building.
The building immediately behind is currently being used as a psychological sanitarium or asylum, if you will, still by the state of Arkansas.
Go ahead, TJ. What did you just see?
I just saw, I was coming down here to go towards there. I just saw, I swear to God, a full apparition of a nurse. I mean, traditional white garb. Walk from the right to the left. There's nurses' offices right down there.
Sweet. We'll have to
this night is going
to
rock.
There we go.
There we go. Now we're recording. Welcome to the morgue. Good night, Colin.
Christy's not coming.
You figured it out.
I saw something go across while ago. From the left to the right.
I have a steady secondary
line. Does that mess it up with the light down there?
Mm-mm. I can actually see better, but it wasn't through here. It was just my eyes. I thought I saw something go across. You see where that little silver handle is sticking out there to the right?
Right. Yeah, I thought I
it went from the left to the right over right about where that's at.
But see, I thought I seen movement there, but I thought it was shut up in a flashlight.
It's not different.
But
well, maybe
it's different
wires.
That's
yeah.
What I'm referring to.
Yeah, that's an conduit, electrical conduit.
Your spider webs are just a heads up.
Love them.
Bring the webs, keep the spiders.
Do what?
Old bathroom. PVP, yes. Does echo? That's correct. PVPs do not echo. So PVP, that's echoing, change the audio logout so it does echo, and that will be.
So the surgery one is giving me really bad headaches. It's very strong.
Which one?
The surgery one. Oh, sorry. I think I missed the picture. One of those marked surgery. It has a strong chemical. The one that has the...
I'm getting interference from that IR on that camera. It's a big glare.
I'm sorry.
We'll note just for the camera, this is the morgue area of the hospital. Some things are still original to it, other things have been staged for the haunted house. So I'm taking it that behind us was kind of like the cold room, maybe, or where they kept the bodies, the cold area.
Door number two.
Yeah, the freezer. Well, they probably, yeah, there's two different ones, look.
Right.
This one's awful small compared to the other one.
I was trying to shut behind you there.
Oh, thanks. Make you wonder though, how could you really, I mean, where did they put them at? There's no shelves, there's nothing. They just put them on the garden and slide them in?
No, there's probably shelves.
Yeah. Or stack them on top of each other.
Right.
Because in this other room, there's shelves.
Yeah, but even those shelves in the other room wouldn't fit a body.
Did one of y'all just like exhale just really roughly?
Maybe, would they? Come on. I guess they could fit a body on there. But that means I would only hold two, unless they have
this one. Freezers for bodies, is that what this is?
Yes.
Yes.
Well, either that or they had a very quick turnaround. For...
Yeah. And with TB, I think they burn the bodies.
Yeah.
That is true, so the disease didn't spread.
Yeah.
Yeah. Imagine they use the shelves for the clothing, the personal items, or whatever.
Yeah. Well, these shelves should fit in the world. Tables will actually go in like a shallow bathtub and have drains on them.
Yeah, you'll see.
There's a hole on each end, on each corner.
There's usually holes on the sides.
Yeah, there's holes on the sides and on each corner.
Yeah.
But it's like a 3 to 4 inch shallow bathtub, and then it goes down around the edges, down like another inch, and then up. No, these shelves are old. These covers are old.
Yeah, these look maybe like they're not the original.
Yeah.
Yeah. And this is probably where
some. And so therefore that brick back there probably looks.
Did anybody just hear something from
I
that
did
way?
Too. Like it.
Put the camera on it.
Can you come out and say hi?
No, I heard.
What happened? I hurt you.
No response.
Can you come talk to us?
Just footsteps.
A man, but he's not responding now.
Are you scared of us?
I'm gonna put this K2 in that chair right there.
No, that means you don't come back.
Where I'm laying down right here is a K2 meter. Nothing we have can hurt you at all. What it does is the closer you get to it, the more it'll light up. It'll just detect energy fields. So please, if you can, come up to it, please. Let us know you're here.
I see you.
Is that footsteps?
Is Christy out there? We only want to talk to you. Can you get the answers from you?
The guy that you're talking to was actually living on the gurney into the morgue, and he kept trying to scream at them and tell them he wasn't dead. He wasn't dead. He didn't belong here.
Wow. That must have been horrible for you.
That was my neck popping for audio.
Yeah.
I'm making you want to pop mine now.
Do I hear him talking? What was that?
Uh-uh.
I can't get all of his words, but I can get some of his words. It's like parts of it goes in loud, and other parts of him are kind of whispering.
given his name is Henry.
Henry, my name is TJ. Will you please come talk to me?
What's your last name?
Do you got your strobe? Push it one more time, just lightly, and it'll strobe.
If you want us to stop, then do something for us.
Close one of those filing cabinet drawers.
Or close the door that's down right there. Can you do that?
No, I'm sorry, that was me. It's me shifting. Can you let this K2 up for us? I thought it was a pinch in the back of my leg.
Serious?
Yes. Was that you that pinched me? Who else is in here?
Shut one of the doors for us.
Or walk across the blinking light. You said it's hurting your eyes, so walk across it.
So can you slow it down?
Mm-hmm. It's only at one speed.
Henry, what year were you here?
Just pissed off.
Is that better?
I'm still mad.
Almost heard like it grumble.
Hey, Chrissy's, mm-hmm. Do you see anyone else?
I just see him, but I'm seeing him as my shadow, like the outline shadow of a person.
Mm-hmm. Ew, what was that?
Ew.
Oh, wait.
No.
Why not? Can you let this K2 up for us? I thought it was a pinch in the back of my leg.
Serious?
Yes.
Gary had something come up and whisper in his ear.
While y'all were doing that.
Film it.
Huh?
I'm gonna put you on camera. Tell me what happened. Show me the area.
I was standing right over there, filming y'all and filming through that door, and it sounded like somebody whispered in my right ear and said, "Not a female."
Cool. Did you try and look? Was there anybody there?
I turned around and looked. There was nobody there, and I got TJ. He took some pictures.
Anything in the pictures, TJ?
That's when I saw writing on the bottom of that shelf over there. And I was asking if anyone here has a black light, or if we know if anyone has a black light.
Awesome. Do you hear that?
I hear his stomach crunch.
Sheila?
Yeah.
Does it sound like a female?
It sounded like a female. Just as you said that, I heard it.
Yeah.
It sounded like it was actually behind us and to the right.
So, who are you, Miss Fimo?
Oh, my recorder is over there, I believe. There's a Christy's recorder.
Yeah.
Rabbit.
Okay, I heard the female though. I don't hear anymore, but I heard female.
I heard it. I wonder if it's our nurse.
I don't know. Maybe. Well, we'll move on.
Ooh, what is that?
What? What are you getting?
Okay, just the way those tiles are pointing. There's war tiles right there.
What'd you think it was?
It looked like a person standing right in the door.
I thought I saw that on my camera too a little earlier, but I ruled it out.
But, see, I mean, I can take it again.
Nothing show up?
And again, no, it's the same thing.
Oh, not paranormal then?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. All right. I'll film for a little bit, I guess. We'll switch off.
You carry that? Mm-hmm.
Are you going to bring her here?
Well, yeah, I got my own, but...
Cricket.
That would be easier.
Can you take some with yours, too? Mm-hmm. Two hands. Okay, y'all ready?
I think it's
good. The cricket?
It's scared of the cricket, but cricket goes.
Not hardly. Oh, we skipped a room, actually. Bicycle. Where's American Pickers when you need them?
Exactly. That's a mark. Hang on. Did y'all just see that?
What?
It looked like someone just walked out, or maybe just the way...
Was it shadow?
I think it may have been my light casting a shadow. I'm sorry.
Nope, not a problem.
This is the room that has that weird smell that gives you headaches.
Happy birthday. It's my birthday. What does that say? Surgery.
That's comforting.
Whoops, watch your step.
Watch your step. Is it going to be a maze?
I'm wondering. I don't get a good feeling about this room. Woohoo! Whips and chains, right up my alley.
That's the man.
Not. I don't like it in here at all.
Oh, it's painted poor. Nice.
This is the stuff from the Halloween, but I don't get a good feeling about this room. I cracked a joke coming in, but I just don't feel comfortable in here. There's a lot of restless people here.
Those are projectors.
Footsteps. They sound like someone in boot or like in heavy shoes.
Thousand. Don't hear him.
You're talking.
You're not going crazy. I done beat you to it. Does that even go through?
I don't know. I don't want to take that through.
Yeah. Are you a chicken?
No. That's the rain.
Yeah, but that one closed off before, no. Was it? Or is that a different ramp?
No, that's a different ramp.
Well, here's another room. Oh, I ain't really much of a room.
No, this is a different ramp.
Are you ready to go into Spooky Tunnel?
Let's go in the Spooky Tunnel.
Let's go in the Spooky Tunnel. Low bridge. Looks like
short.
Yeah.
Sheesh. I can see all the way up.
Squeeze through.
Yes. This is not good.
I can't tell if the stuffiness is just from the heat or from.
Could be a combination.
Lack of circulation.
I bet this was a bathroom of sorts or something. Look.
Showers.
I don't know. That's weird, though. Look at those doors. Surely that wouldn't be in a bathroom like that unless it was the main bathroom entrance.
Or their bathing room.
Yeah. Something. Jeepers creepers, check that out.
Yeah.
The little sign.
Yeah.
Oh, this is where the secondary ramp goes. Scared me. Saw myself in reflection. Oh man, look, guys, look at all the old bed springs. I wonder if those were original. I bet you they were. Look at them.
Look at those springs.
Look how old those look.
Wow.
There's tons of them. What are those? What are those right there? Is that a bed?
These are, these are beds. Yeah.
Really?
The springs would go, actually, no. No, these are bed slots. You put the mattress right on here. It's like military grade bunks.
Wow. Is there another headboard? Move down to the basement. Did you hear?
It's a bit shuffling, a whole bunch of shuffling going on.
This was actually the patient rooms, though. Look at the call lights up above the doors. Mm-hmm. All these rooms have them, so this was actual patient floor. Isn't that weird? In the basement?
Wow. So, you want to do an EVP down here?
I've been doing EVP the whole time. Yeah, you may ask a few questions.
Yeah.
Bye.
This
floor
was like a different room for a trip.
See, this is the room we had come out of a while ago.
Who's that at the end of the hall? Are you following us?
Is it a woman?
Don't know.
I'm having muscle spasms.
I don't see or hear anything.
I heard
her
chatter. It sounded like a female.
Well, we heard that one female in the morgue earlier, and the morgue's like right on the other side of this wall.
Yeah.
I just heard it quick.
Okay.
It was like a...
I heard, come here. Where do you, it was a male. Where do you want us to go? Where are you? Over here. Over here where? The man that I'm hearing, he sounds,
I just heard something moving down there.
Is that a footstep?
It sounded like something actually moved. I don't know. It didn't sound like walking. It didn't sound like steps. It didn't sound like shuffling. It sounded like something. And it was towards the end, it's further down the hall.
I'm wondering who it was that said, come here, and that's him. Maybe telling us to come down there. Take some photos her way.
You got goosebumps?
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yes, I can hear you. I answered you.
Did someone just... Psst.
No. Camera.
It may have been camera.
Can you give us a room number?
TJ, you want camera for a while? I'm going to focus and concentrate and listen to... Because apparently he's wanting attention.
Can you come towards us?
Go into and stay in. One of these rooms yours? Come on, you gotta talk to me.
What can we do to help you?
Let me go home.
What is your name?
Thomas.
Well, Thomas, how can we help you? What is your last name? Thomas Jacobs. How old are you, Thomas?
39.
He's 39 years old. Did you hear him talking?
Yeah.
Hey, I just heard that. Okay.
Has it pegged me on the room yet?
Thomas, how long have you been here?
Doesn't know, a long time.
Do you know that you're dead?
Not dead, just sick.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry that you're sick.
My numbers are
painful. Do you have TV?
Yeah, he's showing coughing up blood.
Did you die here?
Again, he's saying not dead, just sick.
So he doesn't know.
Better he doesn't recognize it.
Are we getting closer to you?
No response.
Thomas, we're here to help you. You gotta let us know where you are.
He says one of the nurses is making him sicker.
Do you know how she's doing that?
What'd he say?
This is Mule Skinner. Be advised, we have audible voices on too. We have audible voices on too. Over.
He got pretty belligerent with the nurse.
He got what?
Pretty belligerent, almost like he attacked her.
Thomas, tell us what room you're in, please.
Sonny doesn't stay in the room anymore.
Are you in the hallway?
I wonder why they have this one locked. Behind you, he said.
See?
Yep, that's what I heard him.
I heard that earlier. He just said behind you.
He's down there. Christy, come look at this. Right there.
Is that the toy in the hall? Okay, we won't focus that quick.
Is that you shaking the camera or shaking it?
No,
that's the strobe. Or is that a
shadow? It's a strobe.
No, I meant I saw black right here. Is that someone moving it? It like comes out to the side, but it's a big shadow.
Thomas, can you give us a sign of where you're at?
I'm in. I don't know.
I just heard a whisper, but I couldn't understand.
Thomas, are you all the way at the end of the hall?
Down by the connection inside the batteries.
Down by the connection.
Where is he at?
He says down by the connection.
Connection. What do you mean by the connection?
The middle.
The middle. Do you mind if we come down and see you? Can you please walk with that camera down there? It's a ring of red lights. They will not hurt you. Just walk by and let us know you're there.
Can you do that, please?
Yes. I was really upset. They brought him here. He didn't want to come here.
Thomas, can you show yourself to us, please?
I actually see him.
Do you?
Mm-hmm.
It's weird.
See where that white thing is? Yes. On the left side. He's to the right of that, standing right there.
I see him.
Someone taps. Did you hear that? I heard someone.
I heard footsteps. Or, like...
Someone taps.
Are you still here with us?
How long have you been here?
She doesn't know.
What year is it? What's the last year you remember?
She doesn't know. She's confused. Kind of feels like maybe the 40s though, maybe 47, 48.
How old are you?
I'm sorry. 27.
You're young.
You have any children?
Did you hear that?
No.
I heard it. Went and shuffle or movement back behind us.
I just took a step.
He just took a step. And it kind of slid.
No. It was a woman hoeing.
They had reports of a woman hoeing here, approached it, mm-hmm. and shot them.
Here, get this on video. On the wall. It sounded like a woman humming, and it sounded kind of like she did.
Mm-hmm.
Just like that.
Was that you humming?
I'm in.
Yeah. She likes to sing.
Can you do it again, please?
One more time.
A male laugh behind us.
I heard that.
A male laugh behind us.
I heard that. Thomas, is that you?
Yeah.
What are you laughing at?
You hear that down there?
Miss Jelena, can you sing me a pretty song?
She likes Southern gospel.
Do I?
Can you sing the old rugged cross for me? My mama used to sing that for me.
She's singing. She did what you asked. She's singing.
I can't hear it.
She's singing. She said she sounds pretty good.
Can you sing a little louder? Some of us are hard hearing.
I just saw a shadow move down there. Or maybe it's the leaves from that fake tree.
Can we come towards you?
I'm going to take your picture. Can I take your picture, Jelena?
No, it's me shifting and my camera making a new noise.
Jelena, what is your last name? Is she still singing? Because I thought I heard something.
Mm-hmm. Yes, she is.
Can you come closer to us?
Good.
It's not going to scuff against the wall.
She says she used to sing in our church.
Which church did you go to?
Methodist.
In what town?
Little Rock.
Okay, did you see that?
No.
All the way down at the end. Something went right across that window. From right to left.
Your video wasn't very bright.
She's still singing, isn't she?
Mm-hmm.
This is Selma.
She kind of has a medium-pitched voice. And she's very, she's not like a goaty type singer, you know what I mean? That don't like really shakes her voice, but she's got the little twang that goes on.
Mm-hmm. Not a whole lot of vibrato, but.
Mm-hmm. You have a beautiful voice.
Very beautiful.
Can you come closer to us, please? So we can hear you better?
She's singing some song now. I don't know what it is. Something about the mountains and the river, and never heard that one.
What song are you singing?
Crossing over to meet the Savior.
Okay.
Crossing over the river to meet the Savior.
Maybe what she did.
Mm-hmm. Is there a reason why you stay here?
Just to help.
To help the other patients?
Oh my gosh.
What?
I kind of feel like maybe she came and visited on maybe part of like ministries or something. I don't even know if that was allowed. Would that have been at a TB hospital?
There would have been strict rules about it.
But I kind of feel like she has it though too, so I don't know if.
Wow.
What's wrong, Gary? Camera.
I put a brand new battery in this before we got started and it just went.
Yeah, they do that.
They do that.
Just like.
They do that really bad.
She might have thought she was coming here and they discovered as she was here visiting that she had symptoms herself.
Yeah, because it feels like she had TB. Did you hear that?
That's me.
That was Sheila. Mm-hmm.
Oh, okay. But it
Ms.
feels
Jelena?
Like she went, like she sang to them and she ministered to them.
Well, she could have done that as a patient too.
Miss Jolene, in my hand I have a voice recorder. If you'd like, you can come up and speak into it. Let us know what you need to say. We can pass anything on to you for you. We would love to help you.
Do you have a message for anyone?
No, she says she's waiting until Christ comes back.
Until what?
Until Christ comes back. She's waiting. Mm-hmm. She's here to help until Christ comes back.
Do you know how many are here?
Many.
How many
are I think it's probably a good place to be.
Jelena, could you show yourself to us?
So you gotta look harder.
We're trying. Are you in front of us or behind us?
In front.
I thought so.
Can you step out of one of the rooms? Are you in the rooms or in the hallway?
I'm in the hall.
Are you married?
Thank you. you hear that?
No.
Right there by you, Maria.
What?
It was a really loud hey.
Did you not hear that?
You guys didn't say that, did you?
No. Are you here with us?
It was a really loud hey. I don't know if I heard it. I don't know. I mean, I know I heard it, but I don't know which way that I actually heard it, so.
Whoever's in here, I have a voice recorder in my hand.
So, Miss Jelena, what else do you know about me?
She says you're a good man, you just need more faith.
More faith in people or more faith in God?
What?
I'm hearing noise in this room right here.
What are you hearing?
I heard shuffling when I passed by. Miss Jolene, are you in here?
I think she might have been past her.
Oh, we did?
But she sounds like she's coming from behind.
There's someone else down there with you, Christy. I just heard a...
Miss Jolene, are there any children in this hospital? That's exactly what I was about to ask.
Corey, second floor, we heard a female humming.
What floor are you on?
Two. Roger. I'm just coming to see them.
Check these out.
This is a small room.
Oh, wow.
Now, why would you think those are actually on the window?
Yeah.
Suicides?
Maybe.
Or suicidal.
Mm-hmm. Or ones that are going to hurt themselves or something like that, probably.
Right, extremely dangerous.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. I wonder why they're not on the other one. Maybe they just took them down or something, but the boards and stuff are on there.
That's true, so why would they only have them on one window?
Yeah.
Maybe they use this as part of their show.
No. These were here.
Yeah, those are old school.
You can tell it looks like there was wood up there. Look at that.
Yeah, it does look like an old. I bet they put maybe the psych patients that were really kind of out there or whatever. Maybe they put them in here. I mean, look at this room. Look at all the mold.
Yeah.
This has tons of mold on it.
When Maria and I were up here earlier, we were on,
where that tricycle is, I looked down here and I seen a shadow go from here. What is it?
Something just shuffled back around the corner. All right, I heard you. Come on out. There's no point in hiding now.
I'm sorry.
I can hear someone breathing in there. Or is it your camera?
Actually, I have an older gentleman in here.
An older gentleman?
Mm-hmm.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt you.
About 57, having a really hard time breathing, very raspy. I ache, he says, I ache. I don't be bothered. He's asking us to leave.
Didn't mean to bother you.
Sorry about that. It's weird to think some patients are still being drained. Did you hear that?
That was Sheila, I think.
I heard Sheila.
Yeah.
Said you that?
Yes.
Said, yeah.
Did I?
I said yeah, but I didn't say mm-hmm.
She just me.
Really softly.
Did you?
That's all right, man.
You have to really stop and think, how can they not tell the difference, you know what I mean?
There's... Mm-hmm. Never mind.
There's someone just whisper something right here.
Yeah.
No.
I heard someone whisper too.
I heard it theirs because it looked like shadow play down at the end of the hall.
But that's what we heard a second ago.
Gary, did you just go shh?
Mm-hmm. Did you hear that?
I heard something afterwards.
But that's kind of what it sounded like I heard a while ago when I asked you if you heard something.
There was two syllables or one or two afterwards.
Maybe be quiet.
Uh-uh.
Could you say that again, please?
Two left storage closet. Listen, this is terrible. Would I get us out?
That's where we heard
that it.
No, that's locked downstairs.
That's locked. I sucked all the way down.
He did.
Thank you for letting us know who you are and
why. Yeah, shh. I swear to God, I just heard shuffling coming from that door we just came in.
Which door were you talking about?
Our doorway.
Like footsteps behind you?
Like footsteps moving, shuffling, rustling around in that stairwell.
Hmm.
Which that's the stairwell that Mark got touched in.
I thought that one was locked.
Downstairs, but this is the stairwell to go up to the fifth floor.
Okay, so we have to come up this one in order to get up to the fifth floor.
And there's also humming down there.
That's what, the shuffling?
No, humming.
Humming.
The humming?
Yes.
That would be Jelena. Mm-hmm. Very cool.
I don't see anything on this.
Hello?
Run down that one, right?
Who are you? Oh, I just saw something. Right in front of us, moved from top down and then directly to it. There it is again. It's doing a circle.
Is it like dust?
It's a light anomaly. No, I don't see any other dust.
Is it still there?
No. It was up there and it came down and went like that.
You gotta know what's down here.
The what?
There it is again.
Moving the wall, so I'm coming a little bit closer, but he's not friendly.
Is he on my way?
No.
Yeah. He's two doors down, three doors down on the left. For it, whatever it is.
Who are you?
Mark, he's fine.
Downstairs.
Radio cord.
What's forbidden? Did you say leaving is forbidden?
Going with who?
You know, that makes me wonder.
If that man's keeping her?
Yeah. If some of them are not allowed to leave.
That's got coloration all over my legs.
You could be the guy who's cussing at you.
Mm-hmm. Or, I mean, there could be other spirits here, too, yeah, that are just hiding and not coming out.
Yeah.
You know, you could have some collectors and stuff who don't let them go. Right. But that's...
Oh, wow. What?
Did you see the lines?
Yes, no. I did.
And as that happened, like that second doorway down, just like rippled.
Sophie, you let this prayer become your mantra and don't let anyone here hold you down, hold you back.
That's weird, forbidden.
What is forbidden?
Leave, did it say leave?
No.
I didn't know if it said three. I thought it first said three. Who are you going with?
Did you hear that?
No.
It's like a little foot, like a shuffle.
Oh, yes, I heard that.
There's someone here in spirit that's keeping spirits from leaving this hospital. You need to quit. You need to back off. You shouldn't keep anybody hostage or anybody prisoner. They have free choice and free will, and you have no right to keep them here.
Okay, so if you'll turn it back off again, we'll use it to ask you some more questions. Will you turn the light off, please? Just a little bit harder. I see you trying. I am. Can you try a little bit harder? Thank you. Were you a nurse before the year 1950? There's something all around here. Were you a nurse here before 1950? Were you a nurse here after 1950? Thank you. Very good. Will you turn it back off for me, please?
Does your camera have video?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, measure the surface right there.
Will you turn the light back off for me? Thank you. See right through to the coolers.
There's anybody in here with us? Knocking there. Did your last chance to communicate for us with us? We have a flashlight sitting on the table in there with a recorder. If you want to communicate with us, turn that flashlight on. Thank you.
Did she get it?
No, I didn't show up on this.
Tell me to do it again, Mark.
Do it again. Thank you for doing that. Oh, wow.
Thank you.
That's really you. We need you to turn the flashlight on and give us another sign at the same time.
Full power. None of these little flickers. Stay alert.
Flashlight. Okay, I'm gonna really really get on the right.
Oh, I don't know where it went. There it is! I found it!
Hey, thank you!
Sweet! Awesome! Thank you!
I don't know. How do we do this?
They didn't know how to treat it.
But now they do.